strange, though. You're not even. At least that was longer.
My bow tie's straight.
Huh?
Is my bow tie straight?
Yeah, right, it is. And I don't like this.
It's 10 after, perfect time.
I am, yeah.
Sing number 18, Bind Us Together.
There is only one God. Today we're celebrating the feast of Lawrence of Rome. Can't help but think of Lawrence of Arabia, but I'm pretty sure their lives were really different. Okay, I've got to find my place again. 355 in the Book of Common Prayer. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose grace and power your servant Lawrence triumphed over suffering and despised death, grant that we may be steadfast in service to the poor and outcast, and may share with him in the joys of your everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated for the reading of our lessons.
A reading from Daniel, chapter 3, verses 19 through 27. Then Nebuchadnezzar was so filled with rage against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego that his face was distorted. He ordered the furnace to be heated up 7 times more than was customary, and ordered some of the strongest guards in his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and to throw them into the furnace of blazing fire. So the men were bound, still wearing their tunics, their trousers, their hats, and their other garments, and they were thrown into the furnace of blazing fire. Because the king's command was urgent, and the furnace was so overheated, the raging flames killed the men who lifted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But the 3 men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell down, bound into the furnace of blazing fire. Then King Nebuchadnezzar was astonished and rose up quickly. He said to his counselors, "Was it not 3 men that I threw bound into the fire?" They answered the king, "True, O king." He replied, "But I see 4 men unbound walking in the middle of the fire, and they are not hurt, and the 4th has the appearance of a god." Nebuchadnezzar then approached the door of the furnace of blazing fire and said, "Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out now." So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out from the fire, and the satraps, the prefects, the governors, and the king's counselors gathered together and saw that the fire had not had any power over the bodies of those men. The hair of their heads was not singed, their tunics were not harmed, and not even the smell of fire came from them. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 126, found in your Book of Common Prayer on page 782. Psalm 126, let us read each verse alternately. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then were we like those who dreamed.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy.
Then they said among the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them."
The Lord has done great things for us. and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the watercourses of the Negev.
Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life will lose it, and those who hate their lives in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. The Holy Gospel, the Gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Christ.
Lord, bless the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So today, the feast day of Lawrence of Rome, deacon and martyr, 10th of August, 258. He's been around a while. So Lawrence was chief of the seven deacons of the Congregation of Rome, the seven men who, like Stephen and his companions, were in charge of administering the church budget, particularly with regard to the care of the poor. So in 257, the Emperor Valerian began a persecution aimed chiefly at the clergy and the laity of the upper classes. All church property was confiscated, and meetings of Christians were forbidden. The Bishop of Rome, Sixtus II, that's a name, isn't it? Sixtus. Couldn't you have been Sixtus VI? That would have been, anyway. And most of his clergy were executed on the 7th of August, 258, and Lawrence on the 10th. This much from the near contemporary records of the church, so it's an accurate accounting. The accounts recorded about a century later by Ambrose and the poet Prudentius say that as Sixtus was being led to his death, Lawrence followed him, saying, "Will you go to heaven and leave me behind?" And that the bishop replied, "Be comforted, you will follow me in 3 days." They go on to say that the Roman prefect, knowing that Lawrence was the principal financial officer, promised to set him free if he would surrender the wealth of the church. Lawrence agreed, but said it would take him 3 days to gather it. During those 3 days, he placed all the money at his disposal in the hands of trustworthy stewards, and then assembled the sick, the aged, and the poor, the widows, and the orphans of the congregation, presented them to the prefect, and said, "These are the treasures of the church." The enraged prefect ordered him to be roasted alive on a gridiron. Lawrence bore the torture with great calmness, saying to his executioners at one time, "You may turn me over now. I believe I'm done on this side." The spectacle of his courage made a great impression on the people of Rome and made many converts, while greatly reducing among pagans the belief that Christianity was a socially undesirable movement and that should be stamped out. And it greatly reduced among the pagans the belief that Christianity was a socially undesirable movement. Interesting. So like that was a witness to them. It's like, maybe they're not so bad after all. I mean, those guys are tough. The details of these later accounts have been disputed on the grounds that a Roman citizen would have been beheaded. However, it is not certain that Lawrence was a citizen or that the prefect could be counted on to observe the law if it were. More serious objections are these. The detailed accounts of the martyrdom of Lawrence confuse the persecution under Diocletius, and the persecution under Valerian, describing the latter not as an emperor, but as a prefect of Rome under the emperor of Diocletius. We have early testimony that Bishop Sixtus and his deacons were not led away to execution, but were summarily beheaded on the scene of their arrest. For these reasons, and others believe that Lawrence was simply beheaded in 258 with the bishop and fellow deacons. On this theory, it remains unexplained how he became so prominent and acquired so elaborate an account of his martyrdom. Lawrence's emblem in art is naturally a gridiron. I remember when my memory came back to this with the, I believe I'm done on the side, you can turn me over. And that's the thing about saints, early saints, that they're sort of like, you don't know where legend ends and fact, or fact ends and legend begin, but that there was persecution and that it was intense at times is well documented. And some of these stories just aren't going to be caught. It's a little bit like our vestry minutes. We have this discussion for 20 minutes, and in the notes it says, discussion followed. So sometimes some of those things, they didn't seem so critical of whoever was taking the notes. But there's observations and legends, and maybe they grow. And I think that's true even in some of the biblical accounts. You know, that they become legendary beyond the fact of what happened. It's not a historical accounting, but a theological retelling of events meant to encourage our faith and strengthen us and guide us. But, jumping to that Old Testament lesson of, what was those three guys' names again? We only said it like 20 times, right? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I love how they repeat that. There's got to be some sort of humorous thing to that, some sort of point, and you know, to make that point, repeating that. But yeah, you know, I choose to believe in a God that does save us out of the fiery furnace. Yeah, I mean, clearly not every time. I mean, Lawrence still dies. Sixtus, whether he's beheaded or taken off to be executed in chains and bonds, either way, he got executed. He died. But there are times when in our lives that God snatches us out of the fiery furnace, and that his presence is there in the midst with us. And that is definitely, you know, the story of Emmanuel, God with us. I think that the early church, with those stories and retellings, greatly inspire us and empower us. And like Jesus's words today in John's Gospel, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it'll produce much fruit. And it's that story that's repeated over and over in the spread of Christianity, that people of faith that are in the midst of difficulties, challenge, execution, and they face it bravely, that God's with them in the midst of it, and that witnesses. So then that brings us to modern day America, and how do we like enter into that without, you know, I mean, what made them have such power, to have such conviction and that clarity? But just to be aware that like that it's part of our tradition, and to step into that fiery furnace and give witness. Not that we're always saved from it, but that even our death can reflect, can give glory to God, and actually, I mean, the accounting of both strengthening the Christians and really impressing the people of Rome, but also like dispelling the rumors of Christianity as being an undesirable thing, that it grew in respect, you know, that I guess we'd say had began to have street cred. Amen. Let us pray for the world and the church.
Let us name before God those for whom we offer our prayers. We pray also for those on our Grace Church prayer list. God the Father, your will for all people is health and salvation.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
God the Son, you came that we might have life and might have it more abundantly.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
God the Holy Spirit, you make our bodies the temple of your presence.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
Holy Trinity, one God, in you we live and move and have our being.
We praise you and thank you, O Lord.
Lord, grant your healing grace to all who are sick, injured, or disabled, that they may be made whole.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Grant to all who seek your guidance and to all who are lonely, anxious, or despondent a knowledge of your will and an awareness of your presence.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Mend broken relationships and restore those in emotional distress to soundness of mind and serenity of spirit.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Bless physicians, nurses, and all others who minister to the suffering, granting them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Grant to the dying peace and a holy death, and uphold by the grace and consolation of your Holy Spirit those who are bereaved.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Grant that the faithfully departed may continue to grow in the presence of your everlasting light and love.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Restore to wholeness whatever is broken by human sin in our lives, in our nation, and in the world.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
You are the Lord who does wonders.
You have declared your power among the peoples.
With you, O Lord, is the well of life.
And in your light, we see light.
Hear us, O Lord of life.
Heal us and make us whole.
Let us pray.
Lord, so fill us with your Spirit that we, like Lawrence and Sixtus and all your faithful martyrs, may have that faith and courage at the time we need it, and that we may recognize the true treasures of the church. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Number 127 on Eagle's Wings.
Shelter of the Lord, while abiding His shadow. given a command to guide you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against the stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give Him thanks and praise.
It is right and good and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this song to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in a perfect obedience to your will, a sacrifice for the whole world. For on the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. After he blessed it, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament, serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask to your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, with him, and in him, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Amen.
The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation.
Amen.
Would you like prayer?
A little different this time.
Oh, what?
Chaplain should also stop and create just the right.
Oh, I know what I'm saying. This guy met him when I was there with somebody.
And start kidding. He's a he's a Mars age.
Oh goodness.
And then all the victims of the fire alley.
Yeah, that's that behind is such a pretty area. People, be with those that are helping. Lord, just our world, we pray for our world that's going through such changes. Help us to take it seriously, to do what we can, and then to be with one another as we struggle. Open our hearts and our homes for those that are displaced. And bless Jane, Lord, with the faithfulness, with the peace, and her grace. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You better know your basis than me out here.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I lift you. And I do lift you and River Kathy up, praying for the best of health, best of travels, best of missionary service and fun, but mainly for God to just walk with both of you as you are over there. Keep you safe. May his holy angels be guarding you all the time you are over there, keeping Kathy very healthy and strong, keeping you, upholding her, and for both of you, being true witnesses of God's love to these people, and may these people So cherish your visit and revel and be the little mustard seeds, the little mustard babies, as they witness to you folks over there and witness to everybody else in that environment for Christianity to continue to grow. And I lift these prayers up to your Holy Father in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Mighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And now may the grace of God send you out in courage and peace, strength and gentleness, love and peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Well, we're branching out here at number 17. Awesome God.